Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Today I will talk about the worst vegetables that we diabetics can take or shouldn't take at all, because we should always have very good and healthy vegetables. But are there any unhealthy vegetables? Let's find out. What I have learned in this life is not what we gain when watching a video or reading a book or an article. It's what we miss if we don't. So please get some coffee, relax, watch, and let's challenge diabetes together. First of all, I would like to thank all my family members, those who join my channel. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. Thank you a lot. Thank you. Thank you with gratitude. Thank you so much. This is the first episode of a new series about vegetables, where I will share with you 5 years of scientific research and my own experience with each food. Since we have diabetes, we should be careful, extra careful with what we eat, and we should always look for the better. We should always look for the better. And we should always know what we eat, why. So we will not raise our blood sugar to a high level. Normally, we should have only 1 teaspoon or 1 cube of sugar in our blood. Sometimes it raises 2, 3, or 4, which is too dangerous for our health, to avoid increase our cholesterol levels, to avoid our high blood pressure, and to avoid weight gain. To be away from all this, we should know what do we consume. Now, first of all, since we are diabetics, we should stop consuming sugar at all, and we reduce carbs to the minimum, and better still if we just avoid it completely. Since I stopped taking sugar and carbs and the vegetables that I'm going to mention, this is how I look like 2016-2017. So scary. 3 months after started this diet, after stopped consuming sugar and carbohydrates, look at me since that time until now, without any medication also for diabetes. The first thing we should avoid, the first vegetable, is potato. The problem with potato is that we all love potatoes. They are so nice, so delicious, so just so tasty. And it's very difficult for us to stop eating them. But however, we have to. You see, potato not only nice, it's full of potassium, manganese, magnesium, iron, calcium, and copper. It's full loaded with these kind of trace minerals. Our body needs it. And it's also full of vitamins like B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, vitamin C. It's full. However, what is the problem with potato? Our problem with potato is, or potatoes, is carbs. The carbs. Each 100 gram of potato contains 37 grams of carbs. Here we are talking about 7 teaspoons of sugar. It's very high, and it will raise our blood sugar skyrocket very fast. Plus, the glycemic index is 80 plus. It's worse than bread when we eat the potato. So it's a no-no for the potato, especially if it's French fries or we fry it with all this vegetable oil. We should avoid it. So potato, no. Second, sweet potato. It's the same thing. Same thing. Loaded with trace minerals. There is calcium. There is potassium. There is manganese, magnesium, iron, calcium, and copper. There is. And also the same vitamins. B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, vitamin C. It's loaded. However, the problem with it, again, is carb. Carbs in the potato, the sweet potato. Each 100 gram contains 40 grams of carbs. That is 8 teaspoons of sugar. Big problem for us. We can't take it. We can't consume it. We can't take it even 50. We can't take even 50 grams. We can't. It's very dangerous for our health. Glycemic index is low, yes. It's between 50 and 86. It depends where you get this potato from. If it's in the high side, it will raise the blood sugar very high. If it's in the low side, it will raise the blood sugar very slowly, if it's 50. However, If the glycemic load, sugar and carbs in any food is high, we ignore the glycemic index. We don't look at it at all. We avoid the food. And don't forget, the name of it is sweet potatoes. Means it's sweeter than the normal one. It's three times the sugar. It contains three times the sugar that we find in the normal potatoes. So it's a no-no for sweet potatoes. Corn, that's the next. No-no. Why? It's really full of trace minerals like potassium, like manganese, like iron, B1, B2, B3, B9, vitamin C, yes. However, the problem is also the carbs, 32 grams of carbs in each 100 gram, small cup of corn. 100 gram, 6 plus teaspoon of sugar. That's very high. And the glycemic index is 60 to 66, which is dangerous for us. So it's a no-no. Pumpkin also high. The problem with pumpkin also is the carb. The carb is the problem. Every 100 gram contains 22 grams of carbs, and the glycemic index is 75, will raise our blood sugar very high. We always should avoid these kind of carbs if we want to keep our blood sugar level under control. And maybe my body is different from yours. I'm not sure. So just try 100 gram or 50 grams and just test your body by your blood sugar by yourself. We need to avoid having this kind of food to avoid the increase of our blood sugar. And we have to be extra careful, but we are not. Most people are not careful of what they eat. They are not careful. This is what normally people eat for breakfast. This is snacks after breakfast. This is appetizer before lunch. This is lunch. This is with or after lunch. This is after food or 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock. They will come and say, take some fruit for healthy life. And the problem while we're eating lunch, we will call the house or home and say, what is for dinner? That is our problem, eating too much. At night while watching TV, we will start snacking, taking popcorn, taking chips, taking this. And then we ask ourselves, why am I too fat? Why too much fat everywhere? That's the problem. Trust me, you should avoid sugar. You should avoid carbs completely. If you have type 2 diabetes or even type 1, you have to reduce a lot of it. And don't eat these fruit. Avoid it completely. And do not eat the vegetables that I just mentioned. And you will see. You will see improvement in your health and in your life. Wait for the next video, for the second one, for the second episode of this series. And hopefully you enjoyed the video. And if you enjoyed the video, please share it with everyone you care about. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.